ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to boys lacrosse action today at the Dartmouth Memorial Stadium. It is the Middleborough Sachems traveling down south to Dartmouth High School to face off against the Dartmouth Indians. Ben Smith on the call for you guys today, and this is the first game in action of our spring sports season. Can't believe we're already 3/3 into the way of our season. This year has been going by so fast. Weather currently is 45 degrees here at the stadium as both teams are ready to face off. It is 48 degrees, cloudy skies today. We got both on the draw. We have both Will Ganji and number 6 Grant Davis. Correction, number 5 Thomas Madden, the junior, facing off against the senior here as we are just waiting for some clarifications from the officials. And the opening draw of this spring sports season is underway, and Dartmouth wins the faceoff on the attack. Ganji loses it, picked up by Masuko, taking it down the near end. Masuko, near side, Howarth. Now towards the back end, Bryce Desiree loses possession on the play as Middleborough will have advantage. This is number 47, Jake Cologuero. The goalie, Davis, keeps it as he throws it right down the field over to Jack Kalaveski. And, just a critical situation there for the Indians as they almost just gave up a goal just to start off the game. Kalaveski. And Cruz saves it. Aiden Cruz, who played baseball last year, coming in here, joining Rossi's crew. Now Jackson Hart on the attack, going down the field. Jackson Hart was questionable earlier this week with a knee sprain. Glad to see him out there right now. Dartmouth started off on Monday with the loss against Plymouth North. 5-7 loss in Plymouth. Howarth near side. Back end of the corner here is Bryce Desiree. Near side. Spinning away is Masuko. Over to Jackson Hart. Hart spinning around two defenders as he's on 2-on-1. Loses possession. Passes to Grieve as, a hard collision there between Gibson and Caligaro. And the Indians will, after that foul, will have possession. Gibson taking its time. And we got an early timeout taken with 11:08 left remaining. And Rossi does not like what his team started off with so far. And he's going to want to talk it over.
Oh, no, I was trying to get a hold of them.
So as both teams are talking it over, so we're going to continue with 11:03 left remaining. But again, I told you guys earlier, Aiden Cruz just joined the team this year after he moved up from baseball. Last season in hockey, he was a 100-point scorer in that game against Somerset Berkeley, which they lost 6-2. And, like, the first 40 seconds of that game was insane. Like, Govin kept scoring all the time for Somerset Berkeley. Dartmouth couldn't catch a break that day. And then the second time around, Dartmouth tried to curse Somerset Berkeley and pose right in front of their school. And that ended up not working out well, as Somerset Berkeley won on a buzzer, I don't know if it was a buzzer beater game-winning goal by Aiden Marcos. Slapshot goal! Will Gibson puts Dartmouth up 1-0. Just great shot there by Will Gibson. Had the timing, and what a phenomenal shot. Great assist there by Jackson Hart, as he will go to the sidelines along with Gibson. The Indians are up 1-0 with 8:40 left remaining in the first quarter. And Middleborough will take it over. Going down the near end, here is Thomas Madden. Madden going to take his time here, looking for some looking for some players to get open. Throws it open to Aiden Fernandes, and he will take his time. And Fernandes on the attack, going towards the near side. Fernandes over. Oh, loses the ball there as a scrum for the ball, but recovered there by the Indians. As there's a fight for the ball. Both teams are going at it. The referees are ruling Middleborough possession here. Adam McGower on the defense. His first year. You might know him from the basketball team. Shot! Goal! Jack Johnson, the junior, strikes Middleborough up, and we are tied at Dartmouth Memorial Stadium. Just a great shot there from Jack Johnson. Just came off the bench and is fired up after that. 1-1 score we have. And Middleborough Dartmouth, who lost possession there. Ray Gramlich coming down the near end. Gramlich over to the near side, goes to Jackson Hart, shoots, goal! Jackson Hart, 2-1 Dartmouth. Great assist there by Ray Gramlich. And Dartmouth is right back in front like they were. Just a great scoop. Easy shot there by Jackson Hart. So I did, you know, really talk to Jackson Hart, though he's the quarterback for the football team, as many of you all know. And I was talking to him. I'm like, what are you going to do for college? Are you going to play sports? And he was interested in more of lacrosse. And, you know, he's been playing lacrosse more majority of his life than football. And he has truly meant everything for Dartmouth so far. As you can tell, going in today, he already has one goal and one assist. Howarth, near side, goes to Hart once again. Hart. Has time, throws it near side, Masuko. Masuko, the back end. And we'll pass it over to Howarth. Howarth over near end to Masuko. Now here's Hart. Over to Gibson. Gibson's shot no good. Wide to the left. And Dartmouth will regain possession. Now Hart. Grief. Back to Hart. Hart has time. Going to Masuko. Masuko over to Howarth. To Hart. Near side. Oh, bad miscommunication there for Dartmouth as there's a turnover here as Middleborough will regain possession with 5:42 left in the first quarter. A wing and a prayer going down the field as they're going down the near end. It scoops it away. The Indians are trying to fight for it. They do have possession. No, they don't. Kavaleski behind the net to Rowell. Rowell back to Fernandes. Near side to Fregel. Fregel to Jack Johnson. Already has a goal. Trying to make it two. As he is covered by Jacob Nuzik. Defense coming in and penalty. They're going to get Dartmouth on here. They're going to get Jackson Hart supposedly on this penalty. Ooh, loses possession. Ooh. The Indians scoop it up. Try to fight for the ball. Loose ball coming on the way. Who will end up with it? A pinball game to go. And it's recovered by Middleborough. And that would have been a change of events for Dartmouth if they had possession. Near side. And scooped up by Cruz. Cruz goes over to Ben Harrington. Harrington gonna throw a haymaker down the field as it's out of reach of Jack Howard. But they will still have. No, they won't. Actually, Calogero will have possession. Sachem's on the attack. Here is Ethan Fernandes. Fernandes has time, throws it to the near end to Kavaleski. Kavaleski spinning away from the traffic and scooped up by the Indians. And Andrew Souza breaking away from the attack. There he goes. Ooh, loses possession. Ray Graham, like, ooh, he gets shoved to the ground. I don't know how they're going to call it a penalty on Middleborough. They had me for a minute. Hart. Looks for an open Gibson. Howarth. Near side. Scoops it up. Loose ball. Jackson Hart will chase it down. It's going to be Middleborough possession. As we have a Matt Palatroni back in for Dartmouth. Scooped up by, ooh, laying him out.
Holy shit. Is that has to be I hope so.
This is critical to say. That, I mean, here comes the boom. See, that's what happens. Don't poke the bear. When you poke the bear, you mess around, you find out.
Come on, 13!
Behind the net. Kavaleski. Near end. Ooh, great shove. And they're going to call a foul on Jackson Hart. So this is going to put, this is a penalty shot here for Middleborough.
Does he say what number A is?
I think. No, they're going to play on. Spin away. Ooh, collided in between a rock and a hard place. Jackson Hart chases down the field. Here he comes. Defenders breaking loose. Shoots. Howarth, no good, to the left. Great shot there by Howarth. The Indians will regain possession. Masuko. As some substitution changes come in. Over to the near side, Donateo. Masuko. Back end to Howard. Now to Grieve. Now Hart will have time. Hart breaking traffic. Spinning away. Takes a shot. Saved there by Grant Davis. Ooh, attacking mode for Dartmouth as it's taken over by Will Gibson. The both teams are getting physical. This is what you gotta like about lacrosse, is that both teams are going at it. Shot! And that will end the first quarter here at the stadium. 2-1 Dartmouth lead at the end of one, folks. We will be right back right after this.
Thank you.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Let's look at an instant replay of some of the goals. Let's go to the first one. Will Gibson, great shot into the net, straight through. Just zips it there and puts the Indians up 1-0. And then we had Jack Johnson. Sidearm goal, which tied the game up at one. Just about under a minute later. Hart, goal. And that's how we have a 2-1 lead at the Dartmouth Memorial Stadium, as both teams will switch ends and Middleborough will win the faceoff here. I gotta say, the new rules of lacrosse is that, you know, it's 12 minute time. It's 12 minutes. Each quarter is 12 minutes. And that's not been the rule last year, but this year they just changed it up. They changed up the rule this year in basketball with the shot clock to 35 seconds. Near end, which is scooped up there by the Indians, and loose possession near side. Ooh, great catch by Kavaleski. Sidearm looks, passes over to now Kavaleski. Shot no good. Goyet on the pass there. And shots, and saved by Cruz. Cruz just has been electric for the Indians. Now Cruz is taking it down the field. What is he doing? Aiden Cruz, the goalie. That's critical. He said he was gonna do something like this. I wouldn't expect him to do something. Would you expect the goalie? I would have wanted him to see him score. He did that last game, shoots, ricochets off the ground, and ball will stay in Dartmouth's favor. All right, let's look at a replay of the goalie. He just saves it, and he's like, get out of my way. And just takes it all the way. I have never seen something like that ever in my life. I've never seen a soccer goalie do that, nor a lacrosse goalie. I mean, he said today that he might do something like that. Gibson loses possession. I mean, he told me, I'm in his algebra class, so he told me today that, should I run down the field and try to score a goal? At one moment, shot off there, and Middleborough will turn over. I didn't believe him. Honestly, I didn't believe him. I thought he was being all nonsensical about it, but Jackson Hart, great defense, loses possession, but scooped up there by Fernandes. Fernandes spinning away from traffic, going to the near end, tripped up. Shot, goal. Are they going to call it? No. That shouldn't be a goal, though. Are they going to call this a goal? No, they're not. And it looked like he, I don't know. I think it was interference there or a foul. No, they're not going to call it a goal on Dartmouth, on Middleborough. Or are they? All right. That was confusing for a minute. I'm like, what is going on? Hart, near side, Gibson, shot! Oh! Just a little bit too high. Hart in traffic. Donateo back to Hart. Still got time. Near side, Gibson. Got all the time in the world. You're going over to Hart. Shot saved right in the stick of Grant Davis. Net, perhaps. Shot, another save. I gotta tell you, both goalies are on a move today. Oh, and now Cruz is trying to do it again, but this time no avail. A fight for possession between Gramlich and Masuko as Middleborough will have possession. And a booming hit there from Adam Agower. Jackson Hart scoops up. Possession. And Gramlich will take a breather as Grieve comes in for Hart. Gramlich. Near side. Howarth. And I think we got a penalty here. The officials will talk it over as Hart will go to the side for a breather for a minute. Now Bryce Desiree has possession. Near side, Masuko over to Gibson. Now Grieve back end to Howarth. Howarth back to Jackson Hart. I'm mistaken. There was a substitution that came in for Adam Agower. Loose ball. Ooh, Howarth had an easy goal there. Howarth, all the time in the world. Back to Hart. Now behind the net to Grieve. Grieve to Gibson. Right now, Grieve, right in front. Save! Right in the glove. Grant Davis, a great save. I don't know why I said glove, but like right in the stick. Collision. And Ben Harrington just wings it down the field and scooped up from Desiree. Near end. Ooh, ricochets off of Caligaro. Jake Caligaro, the senior for Middleborough, will the Indians have possession. Hart, near side Gibson, back to Hart. And ooh, collision there between Hart and Jack Johnson. Scooped up Jackson Hart. Correction, Gibson again. Scooped up near side, looks for Grieve, but unable to scoop it up near end. Here's Masuko. Masuko spinning away from traffic. Masuko shoots, he gets it! Goal! Lennox Masuko! And Dartmouth extends their lead by two. Now look at this, spinning away from traffic and just making it look easy there. Just a great shot there by Lennox Masuko. I believe that's his first goal of the season, if I'm not mistaken. And the Indians will win the faceoff once again. Gramlich will toss it over to Grieve as he comes off the bench. And Gramlich is back on the bench for Dartmouth. Hart back in. Back end. Desiree now to Howarth. Howarth has time. Goes to the near end to Gibson. Gibson back to Howarth. Loses possession. Howarth spins away. Howarth. Sidearm. Ooh, great pass, but to no avail. And Middleborough. Dartmouth gives up possession there. Middleborough will have the ball with 4:14 left. Throwing it right down the field to Kavaleski. Spin away. Harrington. Near side. Back over to Jack Johnson. Shot no good. And possession will go to Dartmouth. Just throws it right down the field over and turns it over. Jake Caligaro. Correction there as the Indians try to chase it down as that will sail out of bounds there. Three minutes left remaining. Ooh, Jackson Hart, a collision there. At the near end, as this is getting physical, man. Dartmouth is just completely bullying these kids today. Let's look at an instant replay. Boom. See, that's why you don't mess with the football players, both Ray Gramlich and Jackson Hart. Sidearm. Shot no good. And back to the near end. Spins away from traffic. And ooh, Ben Arrington, a hockey player. Don't mess with them, they shoot it, and a goal. Aiden Fernandes puts Middleborough at a 2-3 game with 2:23 left remaining. Instant replay time. I mean, Cruz was totally unaware of it coming his own way. I mean, it was a critical mistake by Cruz there, as Middleborough is 1 point away on tying this contest. And and Middleborough scoops it up. Jackson Hart, near end. Hart. Ooh, we tricked the cameraman there on that end. Back over to Gibson, now Howarth. Although both teams have just great, I mean, Middleborough has some good roster, good players on their roster, some young players actually, some sophomores on the team. Their JV team is mostly freshmen and eighth graders. Mostly freshmen and two eighth graders on the team. But a timeout for both sides as they will take a breather with 1:25 left remaining. All right. So we're gonna look at an instant replay by the two goals. Masuko spinning away and gets the goal there for Dartmouth. Lennox Masuko. And then we have Aiden Fernandes, a total miscue there from Aiden Cruz, as he was kind of not well aware of where that was going, as the Indians will try to hopefully drop something with 1:25 left remaining in the first half of play. Hoping you all are enjoying your wonderful week. as I am. It's finally April, thank goodness. I gotta say, if I'm ready for the warm weather and the summer parties coming up in just a few months. But this is just the start of action here as Kavaleski spinning away from traffic. Shot! Saved there from Cruz. And Harrington will just throw a haymaker down the field. And Bryce Desiree trying to scoop it up. Will he? Yes, he will. As he's covered there by Eric Cutler. Now Hart. He's got time. With 22 seconds left remaining, he could just waste it all. Seven seconds to go. Right in front, Howarth. What's he gonna do? Sidearm, no good. And that will be the end of the first half of play here at Dartmouth Memorial Stadium. 3-2 score after one. We'll be right back right after this. And welcome back to action here at the correction. I'm used to basketball season. Anyways, Dartmouth Memorial Stadium here in Dartmouth, Massachusetts. Cloudy, cold spring day here, and the Indians are up 3-2 at the end of one half. Ben Smith on the call for you guys today, and we are currently getting ready to go back into action here. Early goals today are coming from both Will are coming from Will Gibson for Dartmouth. Will Gibson, Jackson Hart, and Lennox Masuko. For the Middleborough Sachems, we got Jack Johnson and Aiden Fernandes with a goal for a piece for Middleborough. We're about to get ready for the second half action here. Ganji face off against Thomas Madden. And a scuffle as the Indians will have it. Ganji wins the face off. Now over to Jackson Hart. Hart down the near field. Hart has time. Near end. Now here's Gibson. Again, back to the near side. And Gibson loses possession. And a scuffle for possession as the Indians will regain it. Lennox Masuko has just been himself today. Howarth over to Grieve. Grieve to Desiree. Bryce Desiree to Hart. Hart over to Gibson. Now Grieve. Howarth. Masuko back to Desiree. Now we're playing Cirque du Soleil. As it's going around. Ring around the Rosie. Shot. Goal! Lennox Masuko. 4-3. There was miscommunication there at the end, but four to two. The Indians.
It's okay. I don't care.
are in front by two. And Ganji once again. This has been mostly Dartmouth's way throughout the whole entire game as Jackson Hart is shoved from the backside. Hart has time. Will shoot. And it's in! Jackson Hart with a goal! And there you go. The fan favorite. And the Indians. Already. Not even 45 seconds later, add up two goals. And Jackson, as it's a turnover there. Ray Gramlich down the field. Here he comes. Over near side shot. Off the foot of Davis. And will roll out of bounds. Let's look at an instant replay here. And ooh, yeah. Right off the crossbar. This is a great shot there by Masuko. Got to give credit where credit is due, man. It's just how he has been playing throughout his whole entire high school career. Near side, Gibson, spin around, shot! Wide to the left. Indians have possession. Near side. Over to Grieve. Now Hart. Hart has time looking for an attack. Near side. As Bryce Desiree is in between two offensive linemen. Jack Johnson. Back out to Fernandes. Fernandes only has a goal today. Sidearm, no good. Which will go out of bounds and will stay in favor of Middleborough. Thing I like about Rossi is that he is such a great coach and he's so poised. Like he admires his team really much and that's what I really like about Rossi. Here is Masuko near end. Ooh, great connection, but to no avail. Look, Jack Howarth, once again, another miscue for Howarth. Howard just drawing all the miscues today for the Indians. Not all, but like some of the miscues. I mean, the Indians could be up probably 7-10 right now. Worst case scenario.
I
Caligaro brings it out as Fernandes has possession. Spins away on the attack. Fernandes near side, back out to Fregolt. Fregolt on the attack. Trying to look for some room. Back out to the near end. Kavaleski. Kavaleski attack here. Here he goes. He's tripped up. I mean, they're going to call a foul for sure. And Jackson's going to get penalized for this. All right, let's look at an instant replay. Come on, man. Come on. I mean, he's not putting the stick out. Back end, spin away. Kavaleski is just taking his time. Jack Kavaleski, back end. Sidearm, save there from Cruz. Right in the sleeve. Great shot there by Wyatt Gullett. As that ball will just sail out of bounds, Middleborough will take over position. Sorry, I think it's gonna be Dartmouth possession here. Yeah, great save there by Aiden Cruz, however. No, they're gonna keep it as Middleborough, and it will be in the mitt of Davis. Just in the in the attack for Fernandes. Aiden Fernandes, sidearm, wide, up to the left. Great shot there by Fernandes. However, I gotta say, the Indians just up their new lacrosse uniforms. This is the newest. Their last upgrade was in 2018, so they've had the same uniforms for about 5 to 6 years. And I gotta say, these are pretty awesome looking uniforms. It was mostly designed by Rossi and Jackson Hart. They were both kinda, I gotta give credit where credit is due, though. Those jerseys are sweet and pretty fire. And we got a turnover for the Indians. Middleborough will take over. Ooh! Great defensive play there from Ray Gramlich. And Fernandes just wants it all now. And Jackson just kicks it out. Let's look at the first stick slap. I mean, Fernandes was just ticked off. And Jackson Hart is going to, of course, be called for kicking it. You can't kick the ball. And he is heated on the sideline. And turnover there from Andrew Souza. Here he goes down the field. Andrew Souza on the attack. Here he goes near side. Sidearm. No good. Batted away. Now here's a chase down between the goalie and Bryce Desiree as Desiree takes over. Time will continue rolling. Just an insane attack there from Andrew Souza. Grieve comes in. Inside, Grieve spinning away. Hart has time. Spinning away. Attack. Shot. Goal! Jackson Hart. The hat trick. And he will celebrate 6-2 Dartmouth. Let's look at this instant replay. Great sidearm. And just makes it look easy. I mean, what's new with Jackson Hart? He can do anything. That's why I consider him the bad man. That's when it comes football season, but lacrosse, I'm going to have to consider him a bad man now. Ooh, collided. These two teams are going at it. You got to love it. This is like watching Dartmouth against Bishop Stang, but it's not. But overall, it's not a rival as the lights, stadium lights come on. I mean, not the right timing for the stadium lights to come on because, I mean, they could have done it at halftime when players, I mean, it changes the advantage of the game. Ooh, lost possession. But Cruz puts it in his fishing net. Here's Gramlich. Attack near end. Ooh, loose ball as Gramlich will walk back. Trotting away. Almost had an assist there. Ray Gramlich is mostly known for playing middle most of his time. But like last year he was a defenseman for Dartmouth. One game I did against Aponequit, I think he got a goal. I think he assisted Jack on a goal. Jackson Hart, 3 goals and 1 assist so far today. Adam McGower is trying to swing that one away. You know, McGower, this is his first year, played basketball this season. Now here's the attack. Cavalecki. And a penalty. I disagree with this though. That is not a good call. I disagree with this call. Let's see. Come on, dude. I mean, come on. Near side, missed. And will just roll out of bounds. And Gramlich right in front. Shot missed. I mean, this is well anticipated that the Indians were going to play this well this year. I mean, if you look at it, they got such a great team this year. I know they just, they're, I feel like they're going to be a playoff team for sure. I mean, only if they beat Aponequit, I feel like they can be a playoff team for sure. Last year, they didn't make the playoffs with a 6-10 record on the season. But this year, they got Jackson Hart, and he's getting better each time he goes. Shot missed, and Howarth is trying to track it down. Hart, gonna look, attack, shot, off the mark, and that will be the end of the third at the stadium. 6-2 Dartmouth. We have one more quarter left remaining, 12 minutes left. We will have that action right after this. All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to this wonderful game between the Indians and the Sachems. And this is Jackson Hart's last goal that put him in the hat trick with 3 goals and 1 assist. Jackson Hart has just been Dartmouth's best player so far this season, as here's a turnover coming down the near end. This is a critical situation as both Ben Harrington and number 24, Wyatt Goyette, was trying to track it down. Here's Gramlich, shot, no good. Thank you. Now, Howarth. Good thing to know, Howarth is just a freshman, and he's just being... Ooh, I thought that was going to be a goal. Looked like it was rolling in the net. Shot wide to the left. Hart will take his time. Here's Howarth, shot, goal! The freshman, Jack Howarth! He finally connects and the Indians are up 7-2. We will look at an instant replay here. A great side shot. Just making it once again look easy for the Indians as they move to a 7-2 game. And Hart will scoop it up. And he loses possession and trying to track it down. Oh, Jackson Hart is just bullying these kids today. Jackson Hart is just unbearable to see. Look at this. Just bullying these kids today. I mean, the refs are not liking it. But, like, it doesn't matter. Jackson Hart is just playing a great game so far. Shot wide to the left. The Indians, Sachems will still have possession. Shot and no good. I mean, that was a lot of contact. I'm shocked that they didn't call a foul on that play on Dartmouth. The Indians are just playing just aggressive defense so far today as Fraegel. Ooh! Jackson Hart just bullying him again and another penalty on the field. I mean, just let the kids play. Come on. Just let them play. Just let them play, dude. This is just pure old school. This is like the new NFL rule with a kick drop tackle. And I don't like that either. Speaking of professional sports, tonight is such a great night in professional sports if you're tuning in to college basketball. Shot wide to the left. Yep, we got UConn and Iowa. Paige Beckers against Caitlin Clark, one of the best players in the country. One of the best players in general. Sh- That's what I like about Caitlin Clark, is that once again she has poise in her game. And she sees the court very well, and she's just a great shooter for Iowa. And Iowa's just, hopefully tonight they take the win, and then approximately down the road, hopefully, I hope she wins tonight and then makes her walk off with a championship, NCAA championship. She needs it after last year's after last year losing to LSU and Angel Reese. And this time around, Angel Reese. Ooh, this is a critical situation between Dartmouth here. And possession will stay in Dartmouth's favor. Anyways, back to my story. The Indian. And then tomorrow we got NC State and Purdue, and then Alabama and UConn. Shout out to my principal, Mr. Shea. I have a push-up bet since I'm an Alabama fan. I'm kind of. Well, if Alabama wins, he's got to do 10 push-ups. But if UConn wins, I have to do 20 jumping jacks, which I might have to do 20 jumping jacks. It's going to be in practice, but it's a push-up bet that we have decided on. And yesterday and today, I wore my Alabama sweatshirt yesterday, and he was like, trash school. I'm like, come on, dude. And he wore a UConn shirt today. I'm like, trash school, poverty, all this trash talk, whatnot. We're going back and forth. I mean, when it comes to, I'm a fan of Alabama because I have family on my father's side who lives in Alabama. And then technically I root for them in football and basketball. Mostly basketball, I root for Providence. Providence is now out, was out of the tournament. They didn't even make it into the tournament, which I was boycotting the bracket at first because the committee made, I thought Providence got robbed at first because the committee just looked at the analytics, then the quality of wins, which Coach Kim English, the newest coach since Ed Cooley left. Was complaining about the analytics too, and he even said that they might actually play trash teams so they can get an easier way into the tournament next season. But then you have the Big East Player of the Year, Devin Carter, having a phenomenal season, losing one of his best players who's been assisting him all year. But just now he just, yesterday or the other, Wednesday actually, he declared for the NBA draft. A lot of players just are declaring for the draft. Today, Bronny James just declared for the draft after one season. Oh, I don't know how they're going to not call a penalty on that. They finally do. And they're going to just shake it off. Now, great sportsmanship there by Jack Johnson and Lennox Masuko. I remember those days when people can tend to see me like as commentator. When I talk about the officiating, sometimes they're probably like, "Do you complain to the officials or whatnot?" In basketball, when I played DYAA, I've never gotten a technical foul at all, and that's even shocking to think for our directors. That I've never gotten a technical foul in basketball ever in my life. Never. Shot, goal! And they are just right at it. Their first goal in the second half goes to Wyatt Goyett. 3-7. Middleborough trailing by four. Instant replay here. Just an easy goal there. Now the faceoff. And we'll be scooped up by Jackson Hart. As Hart takes it. Ooh. They're calling everything today, man. Both teams can't catch a break. And, oh, here we go. Ooh, yeah. Yeah, that's a good call there. I'll agree with that. And down the near end. Here he goes. It's Kavaleski. Spinning away from traffic. Loses the ball. And a scrum for it. A pinball game between. And the possession will remain in Middleborough's favor. Back to my story. Anyways, people, I played football and basketball. I've never gotten a technical foul ever in my life. I've gotten a penalty in football. Funny, I actually drilled a kid once and I got a penalty for blocking the back. And like, the whole stands, like the whole, I was playing in Old Rochester and I was in the Lions Den for like, for that moment in time, I was in the Lions Den. But a timeout has been called here with 5:05 left remaining. Back, I was in the Lions Den for that. The thing is, coaches always tell you not to bug the refs. And I agree with it. It's just how it is, though. When it comes to sports, though, sometimes you kind of just got to leave the refs alone. They're doing their job. You're doing your job. So I can disagree on a ref's call, of course, but here and there. But I don't have any hatred against any officials at all. And here's a shot. Another goal there. Now they're trying to come back. Now they're in comeback mode. Another goal for Wyatt Goyett. And 4-7 score. I mean, here's the thing for Dartmouth. Just because you're at a good lead doesn't mean that you can't you don't display effort. You give 110% no matter what the score is in the game, regardless. And back from behind. And Ganji was just hit down the near field. Johnson. Jack Johnson back over to Thomas Madden. Madden. Oh. Just give it over to Fernandes. Now Fernandes back to Madden. I mean, now here's the attack. Kavaleski. And Dartmouth will once again have possession. But again, officiating too at the same time. The worst call I've ever seen in my life, live on television, I have seen was that Saints-Rams game a few years back. That was ridiculous. And if you were in New Orleans, you were in the Lions' den for 5 minutes. Actually, maybe that whole entire week. I don't think they needed some sort of Secret Service behind their back the whole entire time. They needed some bodyguards. Anyways, 7-4 score. And as we move on from this story, because I don't want to, if I talk about more officiating, then I can go millions of ways talking about officiating, but I don't want to talk about it right now. It's not in the best moment of time to talk about officials. And the chase down here for the Indians as it's scooped up by Howarth. Howarth has time. And if you're current, we want to welcome our viewers who are watching in live, and we are hoping you are enjoying your evening on your cell phone or on television right now. The Indians are currently having great advantage in this game with a 4-7 lead over the Middleborough Sachems. A timeout has been taken. We got this. We got a bunch of games coming up after this. As we got baseball coming up on Friday, Friday the 12th against Aponequit at 4 p.m. We'll have that game here on Dartmouth Community Media. I'll be back here in 2 weeks for Falmouth and Dartmouth girls lacrosse. Over April vacation on the 16th. I believe that's a 10:30 game, so that's going to be an early game. It's going to be an early game that we're going to have here on Dartmouth Community Media. And if you are living around town and want to be interested in walking a 5K, We are running a Teresa Street 5K happening starting on April 27th. Go to teresastreet.org and you can donate or even sign up. And then we have a kickball tournament coming here soon over in May here at the stadium. We have a kickball tournament, which we'll probably have a great time, which is probably going to be a good time to get together. There's supposed to be 16 teams in it, looking for the best. I'm gonna have to rack up every soccer player having a super team here. for the kickball tournament. And then within the next couple of weeks, we're planning on Sports Center going down on the field right now, on the softball fields. I don't know if that got canceled though. I think softball got canceled today. That's why we're doing this right now. And the penalty. There's a penalty coming in. With this win, this will put Dartmouth at a 1-1 record, and Middleborough will fall to 3-1 on the year. Girls lacrosse got canceled, so they're going to play next week against Bridgewater Arena. I believe it's on Thursday. Baseball 1-0. Game got postponed against Greater New Bedford Voc-Tech due to the field conditions. And now UMass Dartmouth has not allowed outside vendors. And a goal there for the Sachems. They are still alive with 24 seconds left remaining. Jack Kavaleski. And the Indians will go to a 7-5 and just allowed three goals in the last. In the last 10 minutes here. And Middleborough will have possession. They got time. They got to go on attack here if they want to try to come back on this game. They lose possession and try to, it's a scrum for possession as it's scooped up by the near end. Lost possession. 5 seconds left to go. The Indians are holding them off. One tick remaining. And shot. And that's it. The Dartmouth Indians are moving on to a 1-1 record on the season as the Sachems will fall to 3-1. And my final thoughts is what an aggressive game, what a great defensive game for both sides. Dartmouth came out victorious this one. Jackson Hart played a phenomenal game, you got to admit. But meanwhile, we got coverage coming up next week. Like I just said, baseball versus Opponequit at 4 p.m. We will have the coverage on that game here. Meanwhile, the Indians 1-1, Sachems 3-1 on the season. And for our entire crew here at DCTV, Chad Amaral, our director, our crew, John and Dan, our cameramen, Molly and Mikey, I'm Ben Smith saying so long, everybody.